Did you ever want to run simulations in Simulx based on many different models? Did you ever want to check the impact of changing a setting like the sample size on your simulation results? Or did you ever think it would be nice to automate your workflows from parameter estimation in Monolix to simulations of new scenarios in Simulx and potentially post-processing simulations with PK Analytics, all this with a single R script? All this is possible with the Lixoft connectors. We already explained how to install the package and how to use the connectors to script Monolix and PK Analytics in previous videos. Today, we will see how to script Simulx in R. Several examples are available on Simulx website, and today I will guide you through one of them. Import a Monolix project and simulate a new output variable with the EBEs. In this example, I want to import this Monolix demo project and use the individual parameters that have been estimated to simulate a new output for all individuals, for example, the AUC. When I call any of the functions in the Lixoft connectors, the Monolix suite is called and does in C++ exactly what it would have done if you had clicked in the interface, except that the interface does not need to be open. To understand the code, we will do all the steps in Simulx, and I will call function in the same order as I do the steps in the interface. My R script starts by loading the Lixoft connectors library and initializing it with the Simulx software. In the Simulx interface, I create a new project by importing a project from Monolix. All elements potentially useful for a new simulation have been imported in the Definition tab, as explained in the video tagged at the top right of this screen. For example, in the Individual Parameters section, I see the element MLX EBEs, which contains individual parameters which have been estimated via the EBE task in Monolix. In R, I can also create a new Simulx project by importing a project from Monolix with the function import Monolix project, and I need to specify the path to the project file. If I am not sure how to call the function, in RStudio I can type what could be the beginning of the function name, for example, import, and look at the suggestions to see what is available. All functions are listed on our website and categorized by type. So you have functions concerning the definition of the elements, the ones concerning the project management, setting and running the simulation scenario, and so on. When I run the import from Monolix in R, elements are defined in the background, even if I do not see any new variable in the environment. To check that the same elements have been imported as in the interface, I can run get individual elements and store the output of this function into a variable imported individual elements. And now you see that this variable contains the same elements as in the interface, including the element MLX EBEs. We just did this check to understand how the elements are defined in R, but it is not needed for the rest of the simulation, so I can delete this variable. Let's go back to the interface. So far, I have only imported the Monolix project. Now I would like to add an equation to my model to compute an additional variable. In Simulx, I do it in the Model tab in the box for additional lines. As I want to simulate the AUC, I will write ddt underscore AUC equals CC and apply. CC is the plasma concentration defined in the model, and the value of AUC variable at time t will be the area under the curve until that time. To be able to use AUC as the output of my simulation, I need to define a new output element based on the intermediate variable AUC. And I will use a fine grid going from 0 to 120 minutes and call this output element AUC regular. To define the AUC in the model in R, I run set add lines of my custom equation. To define the output element, I use a definition function called define output element. So if I type define here in the console, you see that I have 7 functions available to define elements in the Simulx connectors. These 7 functions work in the same way, so you need to give as an input the name of the element and the element itself. The only element type that does not require a name is the occasion, because it is not possible to define several elements of that type. So they do not really need to be named. So let me look a bit deeper into one of these functions. The element itself is a named list of what you define in the box that you get in the interface. So for output elements, this list includes the name of the output variable and the fine grid as a data frame. If you want to have different output times for each individual, you cannot give a data frame. You need to give the path of a file, which would be a table with ID being a colon of that table. This is like loading an external file in Simulx here. I run define output element to define the element. If I made a mistake and would like to have instead a final time of 120, I can run again define output element with this new final time, and this will overwrite the previous definition. This is the same as editing the element in the interface. In the interface, you may be used to exploring parameters and treatments for a typical individual before defining your simulation scenario. This is not possible in R, so there are no connectors related to the exploration tab. However, once you save the Simulx project in R, you will always be able to open it in the interface to enjoy all the possibilities of interactive tabs. I now want to define the simulation scenario, and this is done in the simulation tab in Simulx. A default simulation group is already defined in Simulx, which enables to reproduce the original study. To check how this default group is defined in R, I use the function getGroups. Let me run this. I can check here that the default group is called simulation group 1, and I see which elements will be used by default if I do not change this simulation group. Population parameters MLXPOP, the treatment element MLXADM1, the output imported from Monolix, and the group size of 12 individuals, exactly as what we have here. In this example, I want to use the estimated individual parameters, so I keep the same group size as in the original data, but I select instead Monolix EBEs. As I use individual elements, a box appears which enables to define the remaining parameters, which are the residual error parameters in this case. And these parameters are useful if I want to simulate a noisy output. But here, I want to simulate the smooth prediction, so these values will not be used anyway in the simulation. To change the parameter element to Monolix EBEs in R, I can use the function setGroupElement. In this function, I only need to give the name of the group and name of the element. Now that I have changed an element in my simulation group, I can use getGroups again to check that the simulation group will use the EBEs instead of the population parameters. I can see that the values of remaining parameters A and B have been set by default, as in the interface. As I said, they will not be used in this case because we simulate a smooth prediction. But if I wanted to simulate a noisy output and change the values for these error parameters, I could use the function setGroupRemaining to list the values of remaining parameters for each group. Okay, I want to keep the same treatment as in the original data, so I do not change the treatment element. And I want to simulate the AUC, so I select the output element that I created. As I want to keep the individual parameters matched to the treatments for the individuals in the same way as in Monolix, I use shared IDs. If you are not familiar with this option, have a look at the video tagged at the top right of the screen. I change the same elements in R, again with the function setGroupElements. To set shared IDs as in the interface, I use the function setSharedIDs, specifying that I want the individuals in EBEs and in treatment tables to be the same. Now I can check again with getGroups that the simulation group has been updated. So I now have the output AUC regular, and I can check with getSharedIDs that the shared IDs are between individual and treatment elements. I now save my Simulx project and I run the simulation by clicking here. All the results are saved in a result folder located next to my project file. I can do the same with the functions save project and run simulation. Exactly in the same way as with the interface, if I look at the files, a .smlx project has been created and a result folder next to it with all the results. Currently, there is no connector to define and calculate outcomes and run both simulations and outcomes. But this is planned for the next version of the suite. However, with the function getSimulationResults, you can get the results as data frames to easily plot and post-process them in R. For example, if I run, I get a data frame with ID, time, and AUC for the output. And I get another data frame with the individual parameters that have been sampled. Connectors to plot the results as in the interface are available for Monolix and pkanalix, but not yet for Simulx. To plot the results, you can use the ggplot2 library, which creates nice plots based on data frames. For example, here I will plot the AUC for all the individuals, and you have here the AUC over time. If you prefer to look at plots in the interface to enjoy all the possibilities of interactive plots, you can always open in the GUI the project file which has been created via R. And you see that this project that has been created is exactly the same that I created directly in the interface here. It has exactly the same plots. You should be able to start writing your own custom script. We went through all these steps in this video, but we provide many more examples for more use cases. For example, how to create a Simulx project from scratch in R or run a study with different sample sizes and plot the power of the study versus sample size. And we are going to add more and more scripting examples on this page. And you are also welcome to send us your scripts if you think they may be useful for the community. See you next week for another video!